Item number SCP-465. Object class: safe. Special containment procedures: SCP-465 is secured in containment locker 8423 at Site 19. Under no circumstances is SCP-465 to be opened by any personnel ranking above Class D, and then only in a space at least 15 square meters in area. No other special attention or care is required. Description: SCP-465-1 is a large two-piece cardboard box decorated with a faded confetti pattern popular in the 1970s. Other than a large printed label on the top of the lid marked "Party in a Box," no indication of contents or manufacturer are found on any portion of the object. When any human subject completely removes the lid of SCP-465-1, an array of decorations, furniture, and a group of at least 20 people, collectively SCP-465-2, appear spontaneously in the room or immediate vicinity in which the box was opened. These individuals proceed to celebrate raucously and actively attempt to include the subject in their festivities, primarily dancing and consumption of alcohol. Though most members of SCP-465-2 are persistent in these attempts, and several of them extremely persuasive, the subject does not appear to be compelled to participate. Should the subject attempt to leave the party, additional members of SCP-465-2 will manifest at any location that the subject visits for the duration of the party. Approximately 5 hours following the appearance of SCP-465-2, all instances of SCP-465-2 will simultaneously vanish, accompanied by the subject if he or she has consumed any amount of alcohol in the course of the party. At the same time, the lid of SCP-465-1 will reappear atop the box in the closed position, and any damage sustained by SCP-465-1 in the course of the party is reversed. Attempts to close or damage the box prior to the end of the time limit have had no effects on this phenomenon, nor have attempts to distance the subject from SCP-465-1 prior to the conclusion of the party. Subjects that have vanished as a result of interaction with the box may appear among the members of SCP-465-2 during subsequent activations of SCP-465-1, expressing little or no association with their original identities. Of the individuals comprising SCP-465-2, only two have appeared on every occasion that the box is opened. The first, designated 2-A001, is a male disc jockey, and appears with a table covered in sound equipment and other tools, which he uses to play a wide variety of music audible wherever instances of SCP-465-2 are present. The second, designated 2-A002, is a male bartender, and appears with a small, well-stocked bar, from which he distributes a variety of alcoholic beverages. An additional 185 unique members of SCP-465-2 have been identified, many of whom have appeared on two or more separate occasions, most notably 2-A048 and 2-A162. If a party guest appearing as part of SCP-465-2 is touched by any individual other than the subject who opened SCP-465-1, that guest will immediately become hysterical and incoherent, pleading in slurred speech with the individual who made contact. The majority of these guests will attempt to flee from the vicinity, and will vanish upon entering an area where no other elements of SCP-465-2 are present. The remainder of guests affected in this way will fall dead within several minutes of contact. The corpses of these individuals do not vanish with the rest of SCP-465-2. Nor do such individuals appear in future manifestations of SCP-465-2. Autopsies reveal cause of death to be a combination of exhaustion and blood alcohol levels in excess of 1.8. By contrast, 2-A001 and 2-A002 consistently ignore all individuals, save for the activating subject and other members of SCP-465-2. Attempts at physical contact with either entity have resulted in premature termination of the party. the significance of 2-A001 and 2-A002 remains unknown. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-464, The Foundry, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.